If you can see it here, I'm gonna start here on this trailhead. You are here. I'm gonna follow this line all the way down to the bridge, and then I'm gonna come about, that's about 7 to 8 miles, and then 4 miles up to this part. Then I come up the Bright Angel Trail all the way up this way. Here's where it gets real steep and comes up. It's about 20 miles altogether. So I'm starting. It's 7:30 in the morning. No, what time is it? 7 o'clock. This thing is 2 hours behind. Oh, it even says PM. This is totally wrong. It's maybe I'll fix it later. But you can see part of the trail. You see somebody down there. Yeah. They're just cruising along. All right, here we go. There's no guardrail or nothing. You just walk along. And it's just... That's all I need. I decided to go on this whole trip, and then for just because of the stupid video camera, and then it dies on me. But so far it's okay. Look at this. See, here's my foot. All right, just wanted to show you what the trail would look like. I just started. I'll turn on later, maybe in about an hour or so. CNN, signing off. And here's the trail. Clips, I'll have to do short ones. You can see that's the trail over there. Off here. Anyway, down there's the trail. I think it keeps going down to that point right over there. And then I need to... Hey. Comes another solo hiker.
So green.
I know, it is. I was here passed by a solo hiker. They only go to this point, right? I think that shed right down there, and then they come back. Or some people, they go and they somehow there's a trail that goes over to the, see, that's that trail I did yesterday, Indian Garden Trail. Right behind there is the Bright Angel Trail. It comes up from the bottom. You can't tell from here. And then, see, that's where I'm gonna pick it up. I'm gonna go down this one, go down to the river. You can't see the river from here. It's down inside there. And pick that other one up and come up. Alrighty, here we go. That's the top where I came down from. Look at all these different layers. They say the top layer, the white layer, is from millions of years ago when the earth was covered with water, and those are all the sea life, marine life. And these red layers, I don't know what this is. But there's all these different layers in the earth. There's that Indian Garden Trail again, all the way over there. There's a hermit trail, they call it. You see this trail right here? That's where some people were behind me. They got off the bus. They're gonna go down on that trail. They're still walking down. I don't see too many people on this trail. Last year in the summer, there was pretty many. You know, they go down to this, that shelter I showed you, and they come back. Look at this thing. Big view. This is a canyon. All this was by a river. Can you believe that? All right, got a lot more to go. See us. Doing this. Okay, still walking. Hey, you can see the river from this turn here. It's really dirty. I remember last year it was green, but you couldn't see through it, but it was just green. Oh, it's getting windy here. And then over here, look at the horses down here. people are coming up. Oh, there's nobody even on there. Oh, they're just taking people's stuff up. Who knows what they're taking. See, there's a ranch all the way at the bottom. And people who do hike all the way down, they camp at the bottom. You have to get a permit. It usually takes weeks to get it, though. Look how much, how steep this goes. It goes down the zigzag path. It's a little after 8 o'clock, and it's kind of cool out. It's like 75 degrees. It's not bad. The wind's blowing. It's keeping me cool. I think the reason why I ran most of it last year, I don't know, it was like 90 degrees, and it was only 7 o'clock in the morning, 7 or 8. So that was part of the reason why I ran all the way down. But this is the easy part, coming downhill. See a little snow up on those mountains? Grand Canyon. Whatever, river looks like it's overflowing. Oh, that's probably why it's brown. All from the snow, the melt off, and the springs running into it. Right there, I think that's called Cedar Creek, and there's a tree. This is what I wanted to do, I thought I was gonna be able to do. There, that creek right there. That trail goes to the north of the canyon. North Rim, they call it. I'm on the south side, but they won't let you go. It's not open till mid-May because there's supposed to be a lot of snow up there. I don't know. I can't see it from here, but I guess somewhere on the path, they say it's up. It's 3 feet right now. So that's why the river is dirty, because of all... And that's how it cuts the canyon. All the rain and the fall off and this kind of rock, I guess it's easy. It gets grinded away easily and the river just keeps cutting it. All right, time to move on. Hey, a bunch of horses just passed me. See all these guys? I can hear the river now. There it is down here. I don't want to walk too close because I'm close to a cliff. But I'm almost there, getting there. I'm walking pretty fast. I passed a couple people already. This is almost the middle of the Grand Canyon. The river's in the middle. 5 miles on each side. You can see the path. It goes over this way. See it? And then it comes down, goes around. Probably keeps going down. Then I go down to the river and I have to cross a bridge. And then that looks like the trail. See the trail down there? I walk for 4 miles along the river down there. And then I come up the Bright Angel path I showed you before. Got all these colors down here. That's the other path I was telling you about, Cedar Creek. I wanted to go over here and go up this trail. 10 miles it goes to the top, but they say it's closed. Oh well, there's always next time. Still walking. I'm in the shade here. It's almost near the bottom. Oh, my battery's about to die because this stupid thing was on inside the bag. Oh well. Trail still keeps going down there. We're almost there. To the bottom anyway. The bridge. Yahoo. All right, keep shutting off. Anyway, I switched again. The battery died. I put another one in. Anyway, there's the bridge. And then there's the path behind it. And you can run around over here. Last time I went to that beach there and I swam in the Colorado River and it is freezing. I'm not gonna do it today because it's not hot out today. And then I rested there for about 10 minutes, ate orange and a sandwich. And then I kept going. Again, it goes along the river. Okay, CNN, signing off. Across the Colorado River. I think I'll film this part. So that means I'm at the bottom. Finally. But that was the easy part. This thing is really flooded big time. Last time I was here, I was on that beach. I think the water was, you know, like inward, like 50 yards. Yep. How did they get all this stuff down here back then? Look at all these horses. Maybe helicopters. If they had them back then, I don't think they did. They just used 1,000 horses. Well. Hey, look, there's raptors coming down. And let me look from over here. What's the matter with this stupid camera? Oh, there it is. Yeah. Oh, I'd like to do that. All right, CNN signing off. Look, there's walls here. Somebody, they used to live here long ago, 800 years ago. The Ananzo Indians. It tells you about them. Right here. Ananzo Pueblo. Pueblo means home. See that? Okay. That bridge I just crossed. They were carried down by men on their shoulders. How about that? That's trooping. CNN. First bridge. Yeah, that's the first one I just crossed. And because there's like a ranch back there for the horses, and then past more, there's a campsite where the people, you know, they stay overnight. And then this bridge. All those big rocks out there, big round ones. That's the trail. See it? Just goes and goes. Goes all the way down here. Alright, we're out of here. We go on the river yet. This looks like a really nice view. Still trucking. It's not too hot, it's about 80. But it's a big workout going uphill. Sure is easy going down. There's the trail I was just walking on. Comes up here. There's some people there. I gotta go, I guess, where the trees are. Anyway, this is what the view looks like. you have to come up this way than the other trail I came down because there's shade here. I mean, just this little rock, shade, things like this. The other trail didn't have it. All right, to the top, CNN. Oh, in the summer, it was like about here, it was like 115 degrees. Now there's clouds in the sky. This is easy. Just sweating a lot and breathing, but when I seen the sign, I looked just like that guy. I walked right by him holding my head. It was so hot, but not this year. So this is the time to come in the spring or the fall. Not the summer, that's for sure. Okay, CNN. Red rocks and then the white ones. And I think that's it. Still maybe 3 miles, I think it is. I was coming up this trail. There's, remember, I was filming yesterday, or even a little bit today, I showed you the Indian Garden Trail. That's it down there. And where all those trees are, that's the intersection where the Bright Angel goes. Down to the right, through that little cavern. You can see that crevice there. Downside there it goes. And it comes up this way. I remember last year. And when I was coming up here, man, it was so hot. I rested in here. I remember that for like a half hour. I just like came off the trail and rested. Not this time though. I'm just pumping along. Still resting once in a while, but nothing like before. Okay, see ya then. Came to the top, and I hope you people appreciate. There's my buddy, I walked with him a little bit. There's the lodge, it's pretty much at the top. So, that was a hell of a trip. It's now 2:12. So it's been 7 hours. No, five, yeah, 7 hours since the bottom. Oh yeah. You can see people up here. It's pretty much the top already. Hey, that is the top. Let me pause it for the top. Man, it's windy up here. Pretty top. That's the Bright Angel Trail. Oh,
Brandon! Oh, 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 Brandon! Oh, oh, oh,
I know, I think he does.
Brandon! Hiya, Mama! Hi! Oh! Oh! You trying to get your feet?
I put you on film.
Hi, Brandon. Hi, Sindhu. Yay, Brandon. Yay, Mama.
Brandon.
Brandon. He's playing.
Mountain back there, it's called Mount Shasta. Before I was coming here, I see it on the map, it's 14,000 feet. I said I want to try and hike this, but as you can tell, it's full of snow. I don't think I could hike that thing. No way, look at that. This is beautiful out here, I tell you. About 200 miles of Northern California, it started. It's gorgeous mountains all around here. All right, we got to cruise, got along. I got to find a campsite tonight. Later. Campsite, gonna get ready to go to sleep. I can't believe it's still light out here. This is my camp. Waiting for this fire to burn down, because I got a steak. I'm gonna cook out. That's my kingdom right there. I was thinking tomorrow I might go hiking. There's supposed to be a pretty big mountain behind all these woods. We'll see how it goes. That's about it. This campground's empty because it's Thursday. Most of these places fill up like Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. All right, see you later. Not a big place, there's only like maybe 6 buildings. It's right along the main highway of 84. Let's see, here's this sign, what it says. You can get an idea when I start walking, maybe. It's got a gym to my left, the bookstore, the library, cafeteria straight ahead, admission straight forward. This one building here looks like the library. Gymnasium. Yeah, this place is real little. So we got this building. That looks like the clinic part. I've seen people inside there with white coats. The gym, down there's the gym. And there's the clinic. See white coats in there, see them? There's the library. Right here. That's the gym. That building right there is the gym I'm looking at right now. Science lab. This is a science building. It's like 3 rooms in here. Washington. There's a scenic view here. It's called the Palisades. It's 48. It's a canyon. You can hear water down there. I can't see it. Look at that wall though, it's just flat. Shaved. It's like it's shaved or something. I can hear water all the way down there. Probably this trail goes there. But there's a sign here for Mount Rainier, but it's too cloudy and foggy today, you can't see it. There's this sign here. Mount St. Helens, I just passed it, but it was too foggy, I couldn't get a picture. Mount Rainier, see here it is the backbone ridge. It's the highest peak in the Northwest and one of the tallest in the United States. It's 14,000 feet. You can't really see it though. It's covered in, you can't even see it. Wish you could see this water down here. Oh well, I'm gonna... Wish I can just keep this camera on all the time as I'm driving. Everywhere is just beautiful. One of these days, you guys, we gotta go on a road trip, all of us together. And check all this stuff out. These mountains just keep going higher and higher. You just can't see them. They're behind the clouds. They keep going up further. At the top, they're like covered in snow. Even past that, those points, it's all snow. Up further and further. All right. Off to Canada. Seeing this. I was down there. You can see part of the Palisades. See those hills? I was just at the bottom. I still got a lot further to get to the top here, but look at that thing. That thing looks neat. I'd love to follow that thing. Probably goes all the way up to the top of those mountains. This whole place is full of stuff like this. Just beautiful scenery everywhere. You can't believe it. I would love to hike this place. All right. CNN out. Washington, this blocks the Columbia River. That's Columbia River that comes up from Canada, goes through most of Washington and borders Washington and Oregon. They say this is one of the biggest in the world. One of them. It's really wide. I know we were at the Hoover Dam. Hoover Dam's a lot taller than this, but this is a lot wider. There's the power plant down there. Oh, yeah. Wow. I'd like to go sliding down this thing. This whole place is like a canyon. There's canyons all through here. They say a big ice age, well, during the ice age, it carved most of this canyon. Let's see if I can zoom in here. I don't know if you can tell, these are like cliff walls over there. Especially over here, you can see a little more of it. I drove through about 60 miles of it. It's just like, it's like a little Grand Canyon, really little. But it looks like the Grand Canyon, the way it's carved out. This is the Cooley Dam. All right, CNN signing off. Saying there's mountains all around me. I'm right off the highway. There's mountains all around. Whew. Man, it's beautiful here. Someday we'll all take a trip out here. Someday. All right, I'm signing out. Camp I had to take a picture of this mountain. It's Mount Rundle, 9,876 feet. I had to take a picture of it because I climbed that one already by myself to the top and down. It was like 80 degrees at the bottom when I started. When I got to the top, it was like 40. I started where the trees are to the right. There's a golf course right at the very bottom. Well, you can't see it from here. It's a couple miles away. And I just walked up those trees, and then I came up this face, hopped over this little hill there, climbed up that way to the face, and then kept going. There's more to it. It's just behind those clouds. Just wanted to take a picture of my old friend. All right, see you then. Ashley, Austin, look, and you're on the camera. We're going to make a video of you guys fighting with the guns. Wait, you gotta fill up. You have to close the water. And there's George with two guns, the cheater. Two guns against two little kids.
Hey man, they're winning.
They're winning.
Relax guys, hold on.
I'm camping out at Edmonton. There's my camp, my tent. I'm just watching everybody. Austin, say hi to Jiddu and Sittu in the video. They're gonna see this film. Austin, here, look. Sit here, here, no, here. In the video, Austin, say hi to Sittu and Jiddu.
Hi, Jiddu and Sittu.
And Deanna.
And Deanna.
Yeah, remember? And then you also have another uncle, his name's Robert. Yeah, he's your uncle. He's my brother. Oh no, don't squirt the camera, guy.
Say hello to my little friend.
Hello, with my sticky little friend. Say hello to my little friend. Hey, George! George!
Get him, Austin, get him! Around and blast him! Blast him! Go ahead, he stopped! Come on, no, not me! You get the camera wet! Hey man, you got two guns, that's not right. Oh, you get the... Look, we're having a cookout. Nabil's the chef.
Oh yeah, good.
We're all eating steak and chicken. Say, Austin. Steak and chicken. No, don't block the lens. You can't block it.
Let me swear back, let me swear back.
Check, sir.
Huh?
I need to eat a bit more, no problem.
Sure. Salam America. And may obey us.
We miss you so much.
Yeah, they miss you guys too. And there's Ashley and Austin. The Tigers in Edmonton. Follow up.
I hear myself play, guys.
Run everybody out to the ball. Straight out.
It's a righty.
Fire. Somebody get in front.
Take it in.
Steven? Get over in front, Steve.
Allie, stay right where you are. We'll get it, Allie. We'll get that.
Up here. Get ready to go up the line, up this way. Hey. Oh man, not that way.
Okay, Tigers, down this side. Check your goalie. Michael, around here.
Martin,
thank you.
Michael, protect your goalie.
Go after Tigers.
Handball.
Here
we go. Okay,
Tigers, come on. Get in front of it here, Tigers. Get in front of it.
Why not get in front?
Hey, you got it. Go, go.
Go, Clara. Get it, go, Clara.
Come on!
Get over there, guys. Help throw. Go, go, go.
Go after it. Keep after it, Steve.
It's all right. It's all right. Get it out. Just hit it out.
Let it go, Michael. Good kick. Good kick, buddy.
Hey, pay attention, you two. Pay attention. Austin, just get rid of it. Kick it out.
Go up to Mike. Michael, go up. Go up. There's already two back.
That's a good kick.
Well done, Kelly.
How are you doing, Clara? Good ball. Nice pass.
There it is. Can run anyway.
Good kick, guys.
He's got it. Come on. Who are you guys? Austin's friends?
Yeah.
Say hi to Austin. He's going to see this. It's a film.
Hi, Austin.
That's Patrick. Harry in the middle, and you, what's your name, Brandon?
No,
Jordan. Oh, he's Jordan. Patrick's in the middle, and Harry's on the end. What are you guys doing today? Climbing trees or what?
Fighting.
Fighting?
No, we are climbing that big tree. Hey, Austin, you are.
It's cold right now. It's like 40 degrees out here. Look how big that thing is. I don't think I'm gonna go up there. I keep going. Mount Rushmore's only 20 miles from here. Take a picture of that, and then I'm gonna be on my way back. Sounds like there's a party or something going on. Crazy horse. That's supposed to be his arm sticking out. It's gonna take a while to be done. Many years. Okay, CNN out. Here's George Washington, Thomas Jefferson, Teddy Roosevelt, and Abraham Lincoln.
Here we can see the footprints of a large reptile that was moving up the face of a sand dune. Here's one print, here's the next print, and you can see that as the animal moved up, it pushed backwards and a lobe of sand was formed behind the footprint. Also, this animal was dragging its tail, and there's a sinuous trace here between the footprints, which was left by the tail as it dragged.
The canyon walls have always been inhabited by a large number of organisms. Rare species of cactus, birds, and insects. Here a powerful tarantula wasp moves out in search of prey. Its name derives from its fearless pursuit of large tarantulas. Tarantulas and other spiders have long populated these cliffs.
270 million years ago, a spider walked up the face of this sand dune. We think it was probably something like a modern wolf spider. You can see the tracks here left by the legs as the animal moved upwards. Above this area, you can see that they wash out towards the top as the wind probably blew them out. Subsequently, the surface would have been consolidated by a mist, and then the tracks preserved as more sand came in over them.
Because of his interest in how fossils are preserved, David Elliott has paid special attention to one particular layer of rock where we can see the evidence of ancient sand dunes.
270 million years ago, this was an enormous desert that stretched as far north as Montana. This cliff shows a cross-section through the Coconino sandstone. You can see that there are horizontal bounding surfaces, which are erosional surfaces. And then between them, the sand dunes are represented by sloping surfaces which go from upper right to lower left. Those indicate that the wind was blowing from right to left, blowing sand up one surface of the dune and then over the front of the dune.
In addition to the forces of nature that have created the rock walls and preserved fossils, there is an unlikely creature living in the Grand Canyon that has also had a hand in providing a window on the past. One of the oldest paleontologists in the canyon is the curious pack rat. For 40,000 years, these obsessive rodents have filled their homes, called middens, with a collection of bones, pebbles, grass, teeth, and maybe the odd piece of